I love how confident this guy was. In 1731, the King of Sweden was given an incredible gift. His very own lion, who he loved and totally spoiled. Unfortunately, it died young. After a couple of sad years, the king finally decides that he wants to memorialize the lion, so he sends its pelt and the bones to a world-renowned taxidermist. Now, unfortunately, the taxidermist that he sent it to had never actually seen a lion before, and it's 1731, so he can't just Google it. But he doesn't want to let the king down or jeopardize his reputation, so he's like, yeah, send me its bones and pelt. I'll whip you up a lion. This is why you should always sleep with your lights on. In 1991, a man named Christopher Case was found dead in his bathtub, fully clothed, in the fetal position. When police interviewed his best friend, Sammy, she told them about a very disturbing phone call she got from him the night before he died. On the call, he told her that the previous night, he had woken up to what sounded like whispering coming from underneath his bed. When he went to look, he couldn't move. As he laid helplessly, he watched a black figure pull itself out from underneath his bed. Once it was fully upright, it reached down and began choking him until he passed out. The next morning when he came to, he felt his neck and it was swollen and bruised. And then he saw blood on his hands and he saw that there were deep, uniform incisions on each of his fingertips. As he's saying all this to Sammy and telling her how scared he is to go to bed that night, he suddenly stops and he says, "I hear whispering outside my room." Then the phone went dead. This is why you should always be scared of clowns. In 2004, a babysitter had just sat down to watch TV before the parents got back when she noticed something. In the corner of the room was a large clown statue that, no matter how she positioned herself, seemed like it was staring right at her. As she's looking at it, the father calls to check in on the kids. She tells him everything is fine, and right before they're about to hang up, she says, "Why do you have a huge clown statue in your TV room?" There was silence on the phone, and then the father just says, "We don't own a clown statue." She immediately drops the phone, runs upstairs, gets the kids, runs outside, calls the cops. Cops go in and come out with this guy. As the police are taking the clown away, one of the officers comes over to the girl and with a very grim look on his face just says, "We found him underneath one of the kids' beds. He was holding a sharpened screwdriver." Once you hear why he did this, it will change the way you look at strangers. In 2018, a woman was out for a walk in the blistering cold when she saw a teen girl coming towards her wearing just pajamas and oversized shoes. Turns out it was 13-year-old missing person Jamie Close, and boy did she have a terrifying story to tell. 87 days earlier, a man had broken into her home in the middle of the night, killed her parents, and then taken her prisoner. He brought her 70 miles away to his house where she was kept under a bed and largely forgotten about. She was just there for no apparent reason. When her captor left one night, she managed to escape and that's when she ran into this woman on the road. Jamie's captor, 21-year-old Jake Patterson, was quickly found and he immediately confessed. And this is why he did it. On his way to work one day, he stops behind a school bus and he sees a girl get on. He doesn't know anything about her. And he decides, "I'm gonna kill her family and I'm gonna take her." He had no motive, he had no criminal history. This was truly random. This is why you should always be afraid of Australia. In 2014, an 8-year-old and her family went on an extended vacation to, you guessed it, Australia. After a couple of days, she started having this horrible recurring nightmare where an alien would appear in her room and try to grab her with its tentacle. After a week of this, she is terrified to go to sleep, but her parents keep telling her that it's just her overactive imagination. One night, she swears she feels that thing grab her leg and she leaps from the bed screaming. Her family runs into the room and they see her hysterical in the corner, and then they look at the bed and they all gasp. It wasn't an alien. It was a 7-foot-long adult. If you scare easily, I wouldn't watch this video. In 2013, a mine explorer found this entrance to an abandoned mine and decided to go have a look around. He decides to film his experience and upload it to his YouTube channel where he had uploaded hundreds of other videos of him exploring mines, but he never once references the paranormal or ghosts or anything like that until this video. As soon as he steps foot inside, he tells the camera that he has a really uneasy feeling about being there and wonders if he should even keep going, but he does. Everything seems pretty normal until he gets to a section in the mine where there's a bunch of chains hanging down from the ceiling. He hears something in the back of the tunnel, so he pulls his flashlight out and he shines it towards the back, and he sees a chain swinging, and it shouldn't be, because there's no draft and he's all alone, and you can tell he's scared by the way he starts talking. Although he's totally freaked out, he wants to know what's causing the chain to swing, so he goes farther and farther into the mine until he hears something. People whispering in every direction. He gets totally spooked and runs out. If you don't want to sleep tonight, watch the whole video. You're about to hear one of the most disturbing true stories on the internet. In 1921, a German farmer woke up to find a deep set of footprints leading from the forest right up to his back door. Whoever had come to his house had not left yet. After making sure it wasn't just his family, he searched everywhere on his property and his house everywhere, and he could not determine who made the prints or where they went. A few weeks later, his maid abruptly quits, saying that every time she's alone in the house, she hears demonic voices in the attic. Shortly thereafter, he and his family start to hear the voices too. When no one's heard from them in a couple days, the neighbors go over to check and they find them in the barn. One by one, each of the family members made their way down to the barn where they were systematically murdered and stacked in the corner. To this day, no one knows who or what is responsible for this crime. This is why you should always trust your gut. In the early 1970s, a college student decided to hitchhike his way home after class. A car pulls up, a man offers him a ride, and he climbs in. As soon as the car started moving, the student felt totally uneasy, like something was wrong, but he couldn't quite place it. Without saying anything, he waited till the next time they slowed down, and he flung the door open and ran away. 2 years later, he's flicking through TV channels when he comes across this special interview with a death row inmate, and it's just the audio recording, so he hears the interviewer ask the inmate, "Why did you remove all the door handles inside of your car?" The man just goes, "Well, the first time I tried to kill someone, I picked up a college hitchhiker who got smart at some point and jumped out of my car. So, lesson learned, remove all the door handles." When they showed his picture, the student knew immediately that he was supposed to be the first victim of John Wayne Gacy, aka the killer clown, who had killed over 30 men and boys in his clown room and stuffed them into his basement. This is why you should never talk to strangers. In the early 2000s, a young girl was waiting outside her friend's house, peeling the bark off of a tree, when a strange man approaches her. As he got closer, she could see that he was grinning ear to ear and his face was white as a ghost. He walks right up to her and pinches her on the arm and says, "How would you like it if I peeled your skin off?" Just then, her friend's mom yells for her to come inside, and the man walks away. It would be years before the girl's mother would finally tell her who this man really was. Her friend's mom had seen the man pinch her on the arm and had immediately called the police, who quickly rounded this guy up. Plastered all across the inside of his van were dozens of pictures of this girl, but what they found in his storage locker is straight out of a nightmare. In the locker was a chair with hand and arm restraints. Next to it was an anatomy book and hundreds of torture tools. This is why you should be very careful who you talk to online. A 16-year-old girl was home with her mom when she got a disturbing text message from a boy she had recently met on Snapchat. He told her he was right outside of her house, but when she went to look, no one was there. Frightened, she decides to sleep in her mom's room that night, and right before she goes to bed, she gets another text from the boy that just says, "I'm in your house." She shows her mom, who immediately searches the whole house, checks every door, turns on every light. There's no one there. So even though they're creeped out, they go back to bed. The next morning she gets up and she goes back to her bedroom and immediately feels like she's being watched. She checks in her closet, looks behind her door, there's no one there. Then she noticed that the shoeboxes she normally kept perfectly arranged next to her bed had been moved. So she crouches down to put them back in order, and then out of the corner of her eye she notices something. The boy who was texting her was... This is why you should always take your lockdown drills seriously. In 2017, two 16-year-olds were in their school bathroom when the lights suddenly went out and their school went into lockdown. Feeling rebellious, they decide, you know what, let's go explore the school a little bit first, and then we'll go follow procedure. They step out of the bathroom and look down the hall towards their classroom, and they see this large figure standing in front of their classrooms. It's definitely not a student, it's not a teacher, he's got ragged clothes on, and he starts walking towards them. They dart right back into the bathroom to the corner stall where they hide, praying that that man didn't see them. The man bursts in and starts yanking open all the stalls. Not wanting to see what happens when he gets to their stall, they get on the ground and start crawling to the side of the room where they finally get up and make a run for the door. They look back and he's holding a gun. The boys manage to get away safely and no one's hurt, but the police never capture the ragged man. This is why you should never stay in sketchy motels. In 2005, a young woman on a solo road trip across the country decided to stop for the night. The first place she sees is the Mountaintop Motel. It looked pretty cheap, but she was tired, so she said, good enough. The check-in guy eyed her up and down very uncomfortably and then asked her if she was traveling alone. She ignores the question, pays for her room, and then walks away with the key. When she gets inside her room and sees there are literally cockroaches in her bed, she says, nope, and decides to sleep in her car in the parking lot. Around 3 a.m., she wakes up to see the check-in guy using his own keys to get into the motel room she was supposed to be in. A few minutes later, he storms out and slams the door and starts walking towards her car. Terrified, she hides under her blanket as the man tries to open her car doors but can't and walks away. She speeds off and calls her friend and asks her to look up the address of Mountaintop Motel so she can give it to police. Her friend's quiet for a second and then just says, "The Mountaintop Motel closed a week ago." This is why you should never open your door for strangers. In 2013, a woman let her dog out to use the bathroom one more time before bed. After only a few minutes, she starts hearing scratching on her door, which is typically the sound her dog makes when he's ready to come in, but it just seemed way too soon for him to be done being outside. So she decides to look through the peephole to make sure it really is her dog, but what she sees is terrifying. A deranged-looking man is right outside her door, staring intently at her door handle, waiting for it to turn open. As she's looking in horror, unable to do anything, he starts scratching at the door as hard as he can, never leaving his gaze from the door handle. She manages to stifle a scream, she backs away, and realizes her dog is still outside. So she goes to the side window, but there's no sign of her dog, and so she goes back to the door to see if maybe the man's moved. He hasn't moved. Yes, this really did happen. In 2015, a man woke up to a strange post-it note sitting on his desk. On it was a to-do list that he didn't recognize in handwriting that didn't look like his. Since he was up late the night before doing some work, he assumed he must have written out the list when he was half asleep and kind of forgot about it, so he just crumples it up and throws it away. 2 weeks later, he wakes up to dozens of these post-it notes all over his wall, and they're all blank except for one that, in the same weird handwriting, says, "Our landlord isn't letting me talk to you." Now feeling totally freaked out that some crazy person is crawling around his apartment at night, he starts looking for signs of a break-in, but there aren't any. Instead of calling the police, he shares his experience on Reddit asking for help, and one user's comment literally saves his life. Turns out, the man was writing the notes to himself and then forgetting, because his brain was slowly dying due to a carbon monoxide leak that was only discovered because a user suggested he install a detector. If someone offers you this, walk away. In 2016, a man was staying at his friend's cabin in the woods when he decided to go for an evening stroll. A little ways down the trail, he hears someone call out from behind his neighbor's house. He looks up and he sees this skinny guy pop out from behind the building who starts waving frantically at him to come over. Worried this guy could be in trouble, the man takes off running to assist, but when he gets close enough, the neighbor just offers him a fistful of Slim Jims and starts talking about how much he hates his wife. Sensing there was something wrong with this guy, he says no thank you to the Slim Jims and walks away. The next day, the man calls his friend who owned the cabin to ask him what the deal was with his weirdo neighbor. There was silence on the phone, and then his friend just says, "I don't have any neighbors." The police are called, and it turns out his neighbor was really some lunatic who had recently killed his wife and had been hiding out in the abandoned cabin next door. There is no way you can predict the ending to this one. In 1900, a man arrived on a little island off the coast of Scotland to relieve one of the three lighthouse workers that was there. As he neared the lighthouse, he saw the iron railings had been folded and ripped out of the concrete, and a big boulder that sat up front had moved. When he reached the lighthouse, the door was open, and inside there were half-eaten bowls of food sitting on the table, chairs flipped over, no sign of the three men, but there was one clue, their logbook. In the last few entries of the logbook, one of the men describes the winds outside as being more severe than anything he's seen in 20 years. He also says they've been crying and praying for the storm to stop. But why would three highly experienced lighthouse workers that have probably ridden out dozens of bad storms before, and they were in a brand new lighthouse that was considered safe, be crying and praying for this particular storm to end? The very last thing they wrote before they disappeared without a trace was, "Storm ended, sea is calm, God is over all." Except here's the problem, there was never any storm anywhere near their island that week. This is why you always say yes to tandoori chicken. In 2012, a high school tutor and her student stayed up so late one night studying that by the time they were done, the buses had stopped running. Without another way home, the student asked if he could stay the night at her place. Reluctantly, she agreed. When they got back to the apartment, she fell asleep on her bed and he fell asleep on a blanket next to her bed on the ground. A few hours later, she wakes up to the boy standing awkwardly in the middle of the room with a very strange look on his face. She asks him, "What's wrong?" He looks at her and says, "I'm really hungry, let's go get some tandoori chicken." Confused, she says, "It's 2 a.m., just get a snack in the cupboard." And he grabs her by the arm and he says, "No, we are getting tandoori chicken right now." And he yanks her from the bed. Feeling totally caught off guard by this whole situation, she goes into the hall with the boy, and as soon as the door shuts behind them, she can tell that he is terrified. He looks at her and just says, "I'm not actually hungry. When I woke up, there was someone under your bed." This is why you might not want to eat deer meat. In late 2019, a man and his grandfather were out hunting when they spotted something way off in the distance that just didn't seem right. A deer was howling and then lowering its antlers and charging forward like a battering ram as if it was fighting with another animal. But when they crept closer, they could tell that the deer was all alone and something was definitely wrong with it. The deer was repeatedly ramming its head into a tree, and then finally one of its antlers breaks off and it kneels down and starts chewing on the antler. As they're watching in horror, the deer in a sudden lurching movement gets up on its hind legs and then walks like a human into the nearby lake, goes under, and does not resurface. Turns out the deer had chronic wasting disease, which is a new, highly contagious neurological disorder that drills holes in the brains of those affected and leads to a distinct lack of fear and awareness and is always fatal. And now, scientists are concerned it might spread to humans in 2020. This is why you should always lock your doors. In 2015, an Australian guy took 3 Snapchat videos of his exotic birds and put them on his story. 15 minutes later, his buddy texts him asking, "What was in the window behind you on that last one?" He pulls up the videos and sure enough, in the last one, you can clearly see someone is pressed against the glass. Nothing comes of the Snapchat videos, but a week later, he hears banging coming from that same door in his house, and he gets his phone out and he walks over to film it in case there's someone there. There isn't, but he uploads the video to YouTube anyways. The next day, someone sends him an enhanced version of that video where, as he's walking to investigate the noises, someone with a mask on is standing in the corner of his house. He goes to the police, who look at the video and they're like, "Sorry, that is a masked intruder in your home." This is why you never judge a book by its cover. On the evening of August 7th, 1985, police received a call about a mentally ill woman attacking her family with a gun. When police arrived at her residence, they didn't hear any shooting or hear any noises coming from inside the house. Police tried yelling for the shooter to come outside, but when she didn't listen, they went in. Inside was a massacre. All 5 family members have been killed, including 2 young children. One of the deceased was Sheila Bamber, the mentally ill woman the police had been called about, and she was holding a rifle that was tucked up against her neck with a gunshot wound underneath her chin. This case gained massive media attention, putting pressure on the police to solve it as quickly as possible, and so they jumped to the conclusion that this had to be a murder-suicide perpetrated by Sheila. But one detective felt like they were missing something and kept investigating. And sure enough, he found something hidden under the stairs at the crime scene that meant Sheila could not be the shooter. To find out what's under the stairs and who the shooter is, check out the Murders at White House Farm. The more you think about how this true story ends, the creepier it gets. In 2015, a college student was renting the basement apartment of his friend's house. One weekend, his basement roommates take off for the night, so he decides to use that time to get some homework done, distraction free. But as soon as he sits down to do his work, his friend upstairs and his family starts making all this noise, moving furniture around, shuffling feet. It's impossible to focus, so he picks up his phone and he texts his friend. "You guys sound like you're really having a good time up there. I'm not really getting anything done. Can I come up?" And his buddy says, "No one is home. We went to Wisconsin for the weekend." Terrified, he runs out the side door to get a look in the window to see who's making all the noise. All the lights are off in the house. There's not a single car in the driveway. He had been home alone the whole time. This is why you should always be afraid of strangers. In 2014, a disturbing text message conversation between two classmates was uploaded to the internet. Annie and David are talking casually, and then Annie hears footsteps outside and goes to look. She sees someone standing in her yard, and she assumes it's just Dave playing a joke on her, but it's not. Suddenly, the stranger starts sprinting towards her house. He smashes through a window, and now he's in her house. She freaks out, jumps in a closet, and tells Dave to call the police. She tells Dave that he's yelling for her to come out, and then Annie stops texting. When Annie finally writes back that everything's just fine, Dave realizes something. He wasn't talking to Annie anymore. It's what she finds in the kitchen that's really scary. In the early 90s, a young girl was sleeping in her mom's bed when she suddenly woke up for no reason. She looked at her door and she saw her very affectionate cat kind of meowing down the hall as if someone was coming up to pet it, but she was next to her mom and they were the only ones in the house. The girl shakes her mom awake and points to the cat just as a man is walking past the door and disappears into the room across the hall. Before the man could come back out and find them, they both jump out the window, run across the street, and call the police. When the police arrive, the guy is nowhere to be found, but they do discover that the front door was unlocked, so that had to be the way he got in and out. But the mother swears up and down that she locked that door before she went to bed. A week later, the mother's cleaning their kitchen, and she opens up the water heater closet where she finds this notebook that inside is their names and pictures of them in it, along with a pair of surgical gloves. Which means someone had snuck in at some point, was living in that closet spying on them, and then walking around their house at night. This is a highly controversial topic. In 2016, a man posted on Facebook that the local police were going to kill him that weekend. That weekend, he died under very suspicious circumstances that we will get to. Immediately following his death, his YouTube page, which contained footage from his home's camera system, went viral. One of his videos shows a large group of police officers standing in front of his house for no apparent reason in the middle of the night. Others show what he claims to be plainclothes police officers casing his property. But the most talked about video is the one where the van shows up in front of his house, revealing a guy with a fairly high-tech camera who just starts filming his house. The man was found dead in his home after it had burned down, and he was found to have stab wounds on his back and his stomach. His death was determined to be self-inflicted. However, the debate rages on online. What happened to John Lang? This girl literally lived a nightmare. A 17-year-old girl was watching TV late at night when her motion detector lights in her driveway suddenly went on. She assumed it was just an animal, so she got up, drew the blinds, and went back to watching TV. Then a little bit later, it happened again. Before she could even react, she looks over and clearly makes out a silhouette of a person right behind the blinds who starts banging aggressively on the window. The girl stands up and goes, "I'm gonna call the cops!" And the figure stops for just a second, sprints to the side door and starts pounding even louder on that, screaming incoherently. The girl runs to the bathroom, barricades herself inside while she waits for the police, and then her worst nightmares come true. She hears glass shatter in the other room. After a few minutes of silence, she opens her door just a crack to get a peek outside, and standing in her living room next to a broken window is some crazy old woman who looks over at her and starts sprinting toward her. The lady comes smashing into the door and starts wailing on it until the police arrive and take her away. She was a lunatic who had escaped her facility. If you scare easily, swipe on. In 1989, a woman started hearing strange banging sounds in her walls and in the ceiling. And then one night, the crawl space to her attic was open, so she went to go have a look. When she's just feet away, an old man suddenly appears in the crawl space and looks her dead in the eye, before vanishing. There was nobody else in the house. Worried no one's gonna take her seriously over an apparent ghost in her house, she ends up calling a paranormal investigator. When the paranormal crew arrived, they were actually very skeptical until they heard loud banging in the attic and they decided to go up and have a look. As soon as the two men get up into the attic, one of them screams and suddenly disappears. The other, who didn't have a flashlight, starts using the flash on his camera to illuminate the attic. And he takes one of the most famous pictures in paranormal history. His partner, who was in total shock, had been lifted off the ground and tied to one of the beams. That was the last night the woman ever stayed in the house. However, it's still being rented out today, but nobody stays longer than 1 or 2 months. I was not ready for the ending to this one. In the early 2010s, two 15-year-old friends were camping in a state forest with their families. One night, the friends decide they want to go explore the woods around their campsite, but they want to see how far they can get without using a flashlight. A little ways into their trip, they start to hear some whispering behind them, and they quickly turn around, pull out their flashlights, and start looking for what was making the sound. After a short search, they don't find anything, and so even though they're a little bit freaked out, they decide to put their flashlights away and carry on into the woods. After a little while, they start to hear the whispering again. So they pull out their flashlights. Now they're determined to find out what the heck is making this sound. They do a very thorough search. They don't find anything, and at this point, they're too freaked out, and they decide to start heading back. As they start retracing their steps, they see what was making the sound. A woman comes out from behind a tree, crawling towards them, muttering random words. She sees them, stands up, and says, "Oh, I'm sorry. I'm looking for my campsite." They're a half mile from the nearest campsite.
Really weird human body facts that I can guarantee you didn't know.
This one depends on you a little bit, but the average human body has enough fat in it to make over 7 bars of soap. If you lose your hand and then get it reattached, even if all mobility and feeling comes back, no matter what you do, the skin on that hand will never get wrinkly in water ever again. It just loses that ability. Us women are actually programmed to forget the pain of childbirth a few months after it happens. This is why we continue to have kids. We're like, "Oh my God, that was traumatic and so painful. I never want to do that again." And our body's like, "Nah, forget about it."
If you ever get back to your car and see a random piece of clothing sitting on your windshield, do not touch it. You could be the target of an attack. So the way it works is criminals will put a piece of clothing on your windshield, but they'll actually underneath where you can't see it, they'll loop it around your windshield wiper so that when you go to remove it, you see that it's actually kind of a pain and you start sitting there fiddling with it to try to get it off your car. And while you're preoccupied, that's when they're waiting for this. They come out and they jump you or they attack you. And so you don't want to do that. So if you see that piece of clothing, it's better to play it safe. Just get in your car, lock your doors, and drive away. If you're from a distance seeing this piece of clothing, then I would suggest not going to your car and getting someone to walk over with you. You're mostly gonna see this in like parking garages where the lighting's not great and it's easy for the attackers to hide. There's a bunch of examples of this online, unfortunately, but this is a real thing and you gotta be safe. As you listen to this crazy story, think about how you would handle this. In the spring of 2003, a highly skilled mountaineer set off for a one-day hike in a Utah canyon. He didn't tell anybody where he was going. As he was descending a narrow portion of the canyon, a boulder came dislodged and landed on his right arm and hand, pinning him there. Initially, he tried everything he could to get his hand free, but he couldn't do it. He even considered amputating, but his knife couldn't cut through the bone. After 5 days, he was out of water and he knew that he was about to die. So he took out his camera and recorded goodbyes to his family before falling asleep, believing he would never wake up again. When he woke up the next morning and hadn't died, he suddenly felt totally motivated to live. And so he did the unthinkable. He managed to break his arm using torque and then cut through the break in his arm with his dull pocket knife. It took him almost 2 hours to do this. After the amputation, he was able to rappel down and get the help that he needed. Aaron Ralston is quoted as saying, "I did not lose my arm, I gained back my life."
The origin of Thanksgiving actually has a really dark history. Americans generally believe that Thanksgiving comes from the 1621 harvest feast. This was a feast involving the Wampanoag tribe and the Pilgrims. But here's the thing, it wasn't until 1863 that this event was declared a national holiday. And you can thank Abraham Lincoln for that. So where does it get dark? Well, you're about to find out. The first declared celebration of Thanksgiving actually happened in 1637. See, the Pilgrims found the body of a white man on a boat. They assumed that they knew who the killers were, and without any evidence that the Pequot village was the cause of this death, they decided to just slaughter all of them because of the assumption that they had something to do with it. 700 men, women, and children lost their lives in cold blood. And the very next day, the governor declared as Thanksgiving because they were thanking God for the victory of wiping out the village. This celebration of Thanksgiving was celebrated for the next 100 years. So even though the Thanksgiving that we celebrate today predates that event, technically the first Thanksgiving was a celebration of mass murder.
Creepy Facts Part 1. In 1945, Lloyd Olson beheaded one of his chickens, but it didn't die. It went on living for 18 more months. There's a parasite called the guinea worm that can enter your body through drinking infected water, but you won't notice anything until about a year later, when it breaks through your skin to release larvae, and at that point the worm is a meter long. Judith Barcy, the girl who voiced Ducky in The Land Before Time, was killed in 1988 when she was just 10 years old, along with her mother, by her father in a double murder-suicide.
This is why you should never spend the night on Niku Maroro Island. In 1937, while on her flight around the world, Amelia Earhart mysteriously vanished over Howland Island in the Pacific Ocean. Despite an enormous search, she was never found. 3 years after her disappearance, a scientist discovered an incomplete skeleton on this tiny, uninhabited island called Niku Maroro Island that wasn't too far from Howland Island. It looked like whoever's bones these were, they had been ripped limb from limb. But when the bones were examined, they determined they were not Amelia Earhart's. But in 2017, a forensic anthropologist re-examined the bones and determined they were almost definitely Amelia's. So scientists went to Niku Maroro Island and they found freckle cream, something Amelia was famous for using. So the working theory is she crash-landed on Niku Maroro Island and she fell asleep somewhere on the beach. Then, after smelling her blood, hundreds of 3-foot-wide coconut crabs came out of their burrows, swarmed her, and ate her.
Here's the story of Zoe Alexander, the aggressive pink impersonator from The X Factor. Zoe used to work as a pink tribute artist, which she obviously mentioned on her application for the show. When she was emailing with producers, because it's this whole long process, they asked her to send in 5 songs she would sing on the show. None of the ones she sent were by Pink. The producer wrote her back and told her that she should sing a Pink song, and it was very clear the only way she would be allowed to come on the show was if she sang a Pink song. When she got there, interviewers kept asking her these really weird specific questions about Pink. They had her get there at 6 a.m., hours before she actually had to be there, and everyone just kept mentioning Pink to her when she wanted to be Zoe. And when the judges told her she shouldn't have sang a Pink song, she realized she'd been set up. When they let her sing a second song, they played the track in the wrong key and turned off the stage speaker so she couldn't hear the music and would sound bad. And what we saw was a complete mental breakdown as she realized the only reason she was ever brought on the show was to become a laughingstock.
When you finish this video, you're going to Google 2 words. In 2014, 2 Dutch college students were staying in Panama when they decided to take their host family's dog out for a walk. The dog returned, but the girls didn't. After 10 weeks without any leads, a local woman turned in a blue backpack that contained the girls' cell phones and their camera. Using their call log, they were able to determine that the girls would attempt to reach emergency services 77 times, all unsuccessful, starting just hours into their trip. It was also determined that 5 days after those 77 calls, somebody tried unsuccessfully several times to unlock the girls' phones. But the most distressing thing is what was found on the camera. The first set was taken on the day they left and they were totally normal. The second set was taken in the middle of the night over a week after they had left, and it showed all their belongings neatly laid out on a rock, and it showed one of the girls who appeared to be hurt. They found their remains spread out around the area where the backpack was found, and some of their bones appeared to have been bleached. There is still no official cause of death or explanation as to what happened.